So please note it down. Understanding Section 5 is a $2 billion issue. This is what the question for the Supreme Court while they're discussing Vodafone case. So the people has taken a huge sum of money by the Vodafone to won this case, to make Supreme Court understand what Section 5 is all about. Let me try for you once again. So please try to appreciate whenever you talk about income, there has to be two factors. One is SSC, other is income. Sir, you have to understand, sir, there has to have some territorial nexus of both of either of two with India to make India tax this amount. Let us understand. The SSC territorial nexus will be attached to India only by resident status. So if the SSC is resident in India, so irrespective of its source of income, it will be taxable in India only. Let me come up again. If the SSC is resident in India, thus its territorial nexus is through residentship. If it's a resident in India, then irrespective of residentship, this income will be taxable in India, though subject to Section 5 also. But if the SSC territorial nexus or residentship is not attached to India, in that case, you have to see whether income's territorial nexus or whether it is sourced in India or not. If it is sourced in India, in that case, irrespective of residentship, whether the person is resident, whether the person is RNR, whether the person is non-resident, it will be taxable in the hands of that particular person only. So what I want to say, you have to see either SSC's territorial nexus or income territorial nexus has been attached with India or not. If it is attached with India, it will be taxable in India only. Now, I've already made you understand of as to Section 15 as to salary income, say advance salary part. If it has taken in advance outside India, it will not be taxable. Now, let me make you understand one thing more. As I've told you that whatever you write for each and every amendment, it has a different impact. I have few questions for you for SU 64. Let us understand two cases. Let us talk about myself first. No. Say, if I'm a non-resident and I have two sons, one of my son want to study in India. I may be a USA resident. In that case, my son may come to India, say he's a minor, and he starts studying in India. He will be needing some funds. He asked me for some funds. What I will do, I send him 10 lakh rupees and ask him to make a FD on his own account. And whatever the interest he is getting from that particular amount, spend that amount only for leisure part only. He agreed to me. He make an FD in his name, not in my name, in his own name. And whatever he is getting, he's spending that amount. The question is, the spending of that amount will not be a expenditure. It is only application of income. Thus, expenditure will not be allowed as an expenditure now. Now, the question will be, what about the income? Whether the income will be taxed since he's a minor, whether the income will be clubbed in my hand? The answer is yes. So very easy. It will be clubbed in my hand because the income is, the fund has been routed from me. Now, let us reverse this case. Say if I'm a resident in India, and my son went to study in UK, and he asked for the funds. I again send him say 10, 20 lakh rupees and ask him the same thing, make a FD over there. He make an FD, and by that time, my son has become a non-resident. And in previous case, my son has become a resident. Since my son is staying in UK for such a considerable period of time, he's become a non-resident. The question is, whether this interest income, which is earning in UK, will be taxable in my hands, the clubbing will be done.